Every credit card company wants to one-up its competitors with different deals and discounts. But what's behind the marketing slogans? I'm Bernd, Debusmann, and to find out more, I'm here with Shayan, Shakeel, and you're watching Inside AB. So, Shayan, there's a lot of different deals and discounts being thrown around. I mean, could you tell us more about the single-digit interest rates? We had something really interesting this week from Ambareen Musa from Souqalmal. What did she have to say about this?
Right. Well, she really, broke it down and explained it really well. I mean, we've all seen those ads that promise like 2.99% interest rate, which sounds like a great deal. But what those are actually monthly interest rates. When you convert them in an annual percentage rate, that's basically 2.99 times 2.99 times 2.99, 12 times because there's 12 months in a year. That turns out to be an interest rate of like 40%. So if you owed like $100 or 100 dirhams, you would basically be paying 40% of it back over the course of the year. Now compare that with like, you know, getting a bank loan, which would charge you maybe like 14% is what she's saying. You would pay back $114 or dirhams. So that's basically like, you know, just 14 more as opposed to 40 more. So banks really overcharge and then, you know, compound that interest rate. So it's a horrible offer.
And what about those 10% cashback offers? I mean, that's something we've all seen as well, and I think people don't really understand what that actually means.
No, they don't, and to be honest, I didn't either. But what she's saying is that that 10% cashback on your purchases is limited to where you spend it, and there's probably also sometimes, you know, a spending limit. So if you, for instance, spent like... don't expect to be getting 10% cash back for like, you know, 50 dirhams spend at a store. You probably have a minimum spend of like, you know, 200 or 500 dirhams each time you want to get a 10% cash back. But and that's not probably at every store. So don't expect like, you know, on all your grocery purchases to get 10% cash back. It's probably only going to work at some obscure stores or, you know, just a few stores.
And last but not least, I think one thing that really tends to jump out at people is free airfares and trips based on miles and points. But that's not really how it works, is it?
No, and she made a pretty interesting point. I mean, some cards will give you, you know, air miles on a certain airline versus some cards will give you air miles on a certain airline. But even when you look at just air miles by themselves, 50,000 air miles on a flight to London are worth something completely different versus 50,000 air miles on a flight to, you know, somewhere closer. It really depends on where you want to fly, which airline the credit card is partnered with, and how it calculates how you're going to get those miles. Is it a dirham for every air mile? Because some cards, what they do is, you know, they'll give you one air mile of their own air miles, which will convert to, you know, some fraction of a percentage on, like, say, Emirates or something like that. So really read the fine print because you're not getting what they're advertising really in many ways.
Okay, well, thank you. I'm sure a lot of people want to learn more, so go to ArabianBusiness.com and read the lovely piece written by Ambareen Musa, the CEO and founder of Souqalmal. She has a lot more details about the stuff we just discussed, and like we said, I think it behooves everyone to really understand what they're actually, read the fine print, like Shayan said. So you're watching Inside AB. Make sure to tune in every weekday at 10 a.m. and subscribe. Thank you.